Daigo.
So in this game, so Ichiriki has black, and they're still preparing to start. I think they're in the opening ceremony.
Right. Right, we cannot see the players so far. But, well, it is scheduled to start in 1 or 2 minutes. And, well, as I said, Ichiriki will play deep zen. So we should see Mr. Kato sitting down soon. What do you think we should expect of the game?
Well, I'm not really sure because Deep Zen played quite well in the World Championship tournament.
Right, just this week.
Days ago. But I don't think it played so well in the computer tournament, the UEC
right.
Cup.
Whether it was because of a different version or different hardware or different time settings.
It could be any of those, and I don't really know.
And we don't know today's combination either, so it's
and
a little bit difficult.
The time limit, of course, is shorter this time. It's 30 minutes apiece with overtime.
30 seconds, right?
So that is closer to the computer tournament, the UEC Cup.
In the computer cup, it was 30 minutes absolute.
Yeah, with no extra time.
Yes, but we have actually no idea how the program is spending its time. Because we have 30 seconds Biyomi, it could be making one move in 20 seconds or 25 seconds.
Yes.
Or it could be doing in 10 seconds, mm-hmm. which will be completely different. I suppose we cannot help but watch and see on that part. And Ichiriki drew black in the game. I'm actually a little bit disappointed about that. So far in the commentaries we've done, Zen has won every game as black and lost every game as white.
Ah, yes. Mm-hmm.
Including also the match against Cho Chikun, the Den Osen, last November. On the other hand, if Zen does win today, it'll be the first one as white, which would also be interesting.
I think Zen does show its original style of play when it has black more. It's more true to its original style.
It is a kind of very powerful influence-based attacking style, isn't it? Zen just defeated Iyama Yuta a few days ago while playing black, which was kind of impressive, finally speaking.
Well, in that tournament, there were three rounds, and so it played Park Jung-won from Korea and Miyuting from China.
Holding
and
white
in
against
all three
both.
Games, it started out quite well, actually. At the beginning of the end game of each game, it had chances to win.
Right.
But it didn't do so well in the end game. Like, its end game.
In the first two games, it actually.
Losing the games in the end game.
Fell apart quickly. Mm-hmm. As far as I saw, the two games as white, it played the opening really well. Mm-hmm. It didn't have a bad position. But against Iyama Yuta, while holding black, don't you think the whole upper side exchange was not so good for black?
Up to a certain point it was bad, but I think actually, looking at the game again yesterday, I saw that Iyama played too much there and actually strengthened Zen's influence in the center. And that was probably his mistake.
I suppose that is the case. Finally speaking, white had about 40 points of territory, while black had a corner, center influence, and two stones on the lower side.
And we're still waiting for the players to be seated, so I expect they're still in the opening ceremony.
Right. By the official schedule, we should have started already, but you know how these things go. Mr. Sakai Naindan is already waiting next to the board.
And I suppose he's the referee.
Right. He actually was teaching me several times that... Ah, now the players came.
So we have Ichiriki Sevendan and Mr. Kato,
of
who
Deep
is
Zen.
One of the programmers for Zen.
Right. And the colors have been decided already, so I expect the game to start very soon now. As for the English relay, unfortunately, you will be seeing just this screen around here.
Yes.
While we, the commentators, are actually watching the Japanese relay. I I think we are just about set.
We're waiting for the referee to start them off.
Looks like final technical preparations. Who is doing the announcing today? The lady on the right side. I think I've seen her many times.
She's a Go instructor. Her name sort of
eludes
my mind. Yeah.
I'm quite sure I've seen her on television many times. Igo Shogi Channel.
One of the strongest female amateur players in Japan.
Oh, I see. They just had the female amateur tournament,
yes.
Amateur championship, didn't they? But I guess she might not be playing anymore. An old friend of mine actually won the tournament.
Oh,
she was a former Insei. Mm-hmm. Iwata. We are still waiting for something. Once the game starts, I guess things will proceed quite quickly.
Yes.
As we said, it's 30 minutes and then 30 seconds. So compared to the World Go Championship we were doing just a few days ago, this will be a lot more hectic.
Well, we could maybe we could talk about Yama's game while we're...
That would be interesting.
Yesterday's game. Zen started with this.
Yama played in the corner.
Okay.
There was two on this.
Yes. And then here.
Here was it.
So this looked like Black was giving up a lot. It's probably not completely bad for Black. And this exchange was better not played.
The corner edge just disappeared. But I suppose Black's plan was never to do anything here. Because White would become stronger on the outside.
And connected, and then say, oops. And there's some of these that don't have magnets.
Magnets are coming out, yes.
And it was at this point where White probably shouldn't have played this. So this is the result of what I was thinking about yesterday. Mm. I think up White already has about 40 points there, and Black is starting to have thickness in the center.
Right.
But this exchange here, oh yes, Black played that one first. This exchange here actually made Black much stronger in the center up to this point. So White would have done better just to leave it like this, in which case White would have moves like the cut here or the hane here.
I see.
Or even if White just plays, White will have more room in the center.
Any kinds of attachments or
locally
whatever.
I think the cut here is a move that White would be looking to play at some point. And
so
have
Black
the
tries to take one stone.
Outside.
Yes.
And they're still waiting for the game to start, so it looks like maybe the computer is not not ready yet.
Right.
So they might be having some kind of technical problem. So we can just go a bit further. At this point, I would prefer to play with White if White just played
that
something
is
on
the feeling,
lower
yes.
side. Yes. But I think Yama playing this exchange actually strengthened Black a bit too much.
Do you mind if I do a kind of theory analysis?
If you wish, go ahead.
Which was how I was trying to judge the position. If we start from scratch, it's kind of like we had these two stones, right?
All right.
Black approached, whereas, well, Shimari shouldn't be so bad, normally speaking. And so we have a kind of Josuke here. Well, if I just do it simply, Black had a stone around here, White had a stone around here. And then there was the whole exchange of something. I lose the sight of the position of the stones, but finally speaking, it's kind of like White is connected around here, and Black has something around here, as far as territory goes. A little bit more around here. Which, finally speaking, well, white is all third line territory.
Yes. So
while black actually
so
has
big.
Stones yes. facing the center. So it actually might be that white wasn't so happy with the result.
And they're about to start now. So why don't we, yeah.
All right, okay.
Why don't we go back to the today's game.
Ichiriki just started.
Ichiriki has just played his first move. So Ichiriki, who is also the champion of the Ryusei Cup.
It's a television tournament in Japan.
He's playing with black.
Ichiriki's official ranking is still 7 dan, but I think he's right now one of the most, well, he is one of who has the best results in Japanese tournaments.
Yes, yes.
Recently he was challenging for Tengen, was it?
Yes, I'd say he's one of the players who are expected to be next after Iyama. So he's
the next Iyama.
I wouldn't
so to
be
say,
surprised
yes.
to see him start taking titles.
He's still 19, isn't he?
He's 19 or 20. I'm not sure.
Yes. At least recently he was still 19. He might be becoming 20 this year. Whereas Iyama, when he took his first title, he was he 20?
I think he was 20, yes.
It was the Meijin.
20 or 20, 21, yes.
So, well, Iyama has to get, Ichiriki has to get something soon, but he still has time. It'll be Chinese style. This happened quite a lot with AlphaGo just last year.
Yes, yes. There was a time when it was AlphaGo's favorite, when AlphaGo was challenging
Lee Sedol around that time.
Yes.
Quite often also this exchange was made.
Yes, yes.
In this game we don't have it.
And the most popular move now is to jump into the 3-3 point.
Which then did.
Yes. So this will happen. And
after this one, it's a little bit hard to say.
And this is where AlphaGo in recent games has started to play away.
Right. 1 year ago, it would still turn here, wasn't it?
Yes, it had this opening too. This was actually, and having this Kokori also.
Yes, then playing here. Yeah.
And when AlphaGo played this opening a few times, it actually became popular in professional play. So this is maybe the first opening that became popular
because
AlphaGo was playing it. But it stopped playing this now.
Right.
It doesn't do it anymore.
Nowadays, AlphaGo is not making the turn anymore. Yes, Zen also played elsewhere.
And no, that's Ichiriki. Ichiriki is black.
Oh, sorry.
Yes.
If it was a human player here, I think game would be normal.
So I think that the move...
Yes, Zen played it. Was it this Ogema?
I think it was here, yes.
This happened
and
with...
This was played by Master, or AlphaGo, and it was also played
against
by...
Against Park Chung-Fan, I think.
It was also played by KJ against Master, so...
Ah.
And that was a game which, for a point there, looked good for KJ, so it's a pretty successful move. So this is the move that's sort of the move that the Google AI Master played.
Right.
Otherwise, this kind of move is also a fairly common or popular move.
In this case, the corner area is more open, so it's a bit easier for white to do something here.
With Master against Park Junhwan, it was like this.
I think it was a fifth line move, was it?
White played this one first, and then extended. Okay.
Oh, yes. And so black played this.
And then white came in here. And this was always
already,
I think white chose the wrong place to invade, actually. Because this
finally
was already
speaking,
good, looking good for black.
This game becomes perfect.
At this point, it was already beginning to look difficult for white.
Yes.
Of course, this is a position where Park Junhwan is very strong, very good at making the
light. You were saying it, yes.
But it didn't really work out well for him in this game.
Became a kind of, white had two weak groups, and both of them were kind of weak.
And Master didn't even try to kill
Black
this
had a chance to kill this
dead.
One, but
yeah.
Master didn't care.
So let's get back to the game. Oh, yes. black played the more normal extension. This gives white more space to jump into the upper left.
Right.
So this is a point where, in one of the self-played games, I think there was a game where AlphaGo played here.
I think
although the position here is slightly different.
I think this one didn't exist in those games.
There,
it
right.
was this one.
Yes, that's right.
As far as human knowledge seems to go, I suppose the approach is the most normal move.
Traditionally, that's the best move, yes. And white played here first. So this is more like
black
the way
also enclosed.
Played before, yes.
So Zen is not caring about the...
Well, this is a probe that you often see
right.
by strong players. So the question is, how will black try to kill this stone? Black has a number of moves to choose from.
I suppose
that
surrounding here
normal.
Is the normal, and the second one would be diagonal
that,
here.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So in the case of the diagonal, black is kind of emphasizing the lower side,
mm-hmm.
possibly letting white live here.
Yes.
And with the normal surrounding move, well, white can play Hane or possibly here.
More often that one, I suppose.
Go up and start creating group around here.
Right. It makes more room for white on the side.
Of course, white might just leave the exchange and go elsewhere for the time being.
But it didn't. White played here immediately.
Immediately.
And black has a choice of going straight down or capturing the one stone.
Right.
But usually, black captured. That's a bit different.
That's a bit rare. Territory-wise, this one is a lot
better,
right?
Yes.
This case, white gets tari like this. And possibly jump, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
And in the case of this shape, when white gets the hanging connection, for example, it's starting to quickly build eye shape in the region.
The high extension.
Well, white can get this any time, and white is saying black doesn't play here now.
Right.
Which I suppose he will not.
So now black can continue the attack probably with something like this or like this.
Mm-hmm.
Or black could play away. Something like this would also be big.
Right. There seems to be a number of options here. Quickly speaking, for example, if playing Keima, then we want to surround from the center. Now, if this was AlphaGo, maybe AlphaGo would push.
Mm-hmm.
Then, well, white's shape here is too good, so let's enter it. And now if white gets this atari, it's quickly becoming a base here. So I suppose we need to do something about it. Well, normally. Might I try to cut? And in this case, black is starting to have quite a few cutting points.
Yeah, we're starting a game here, so
yes.
Let's get back to the... otherwise, white might have enough room to live on the side, but I feel that white wants to try to move out.
White could, let me see, so attach, for example.
Instead, white played the knight's move.
Oh, so white is getting out. A human player might consider just living, but computers seem to like a...
Mm-hmm. Well, this area is, there's a lot of room here,
right.
So white would like to move out.
How is this for black? The white shape overall looks just a little bit thin,
it's
but
a thin shape, yes.
Black could try poking around here.
Mm-hmm.
White would reinforce. Well, if I want to aim for the cut, I would do this, but let's go out. So black might get one stone, but white also runs out easily. whereas if black doesn't do anything, then white is quickly alive.
Well, even extending here, oh, right, you could say.
Ichiriki has 30 minutes of basic time, so I expect the opening of the game will be a little bit slower. Then, of course, we'll be playing the same speed all the time.
I would expect so. I don't really know how the time controls are set.
Right. I would be surprised, yes, if the bot knew how to allocate its time.
Yes.
And this would be just the kind of moment where you actually want to think on your game plan. If you go directly for attack, or perhaps just pressuring from outside.
Mm-hmm. Well, also from above seems to work too, because white has bad shape here.
So, for example, rook. Sooner or later, this is going to be quite severe.
Next, yes. So yeah. So at some point, white has to fix that weakness there. So this is another thing I think white might answer it first with something like this too.
So to fix the weakness
black
here.
Played the knight's move. It looks like Ichiriki is going to try to just close off the center here.
Right. This is actually the kind of playing style that could be efficient against computers.
Yes. It's the kind of game that you would expect Zen to play with black, actually.
Yes. It actually looks very much so. I would get confused. Let's draw back, I suppose.
And black would extend down, maybe. Yeah.
So we could be looking at this kind of a result, maybe. I wonder if Zen would actually connect here. Still looks a little bit thin in the region.
It is thin, yes. Black could
strike immediately. Extend out. And maybe connect. And finally speaking, there's still a kind of cut remaining.
Yes. Well,
kind of, yes. It'll be a core fight.
It will be a core, yes.
So that kind of thing could follow.
And if white plays once more, white will have a life.
Right.
Oh, it's quite different.
White actually goes to cut first. It's interesting. White played here. So white is saying black needs to save this one stone, of course. So black would normally go out.
Yeah, normally pull back.
So it seems like white is going to extend here.
Maybe just the one. I don't think that's going to work very well.
Black would jump
for
out.
For the time being, black will just jump. But white could just leave it. Like, for instance, depending on the position, sometimes black will play here. So maybe
I see.
It's just a probe to see how black answers once.
As far as human playing style goes, I would agree, but
you don't think a computer would do it that way?
As far as Zen goes, I actually really think it will start a cut here and immediately go out. Because it doesn't seem like white can easily be captured here. There's a number of cutting points here, and the black group here is not completely safe either. I'm not sure, of course, but I would expect it to try this kind of thing.
It looks like a dangerous fight for white, though, yeah, since white's not alive.
If I was playing white, I would not dare do it. It did. But yes, it does look dangerous for white, and I would not dare play like this. Cherokee is in thought here.
Yes.
Cherokee was also recently in the NHK Cup final,
yes,
which is one more television tournament. He was playing Iyama Yuta. And well, in that final game, Iyama won this time. Mm-hmm. Cherokee was the runner-up.
I think Cherokee had some chances to win that game.
But, right.
Yes.
It was quite a difficult fighting game, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It was actually broadcast just last week on television. So far, Zen has used 2 minutes of time. We have Ohashi Sensei here. Where is the match actually taking place? As far as this commentary goes, we are at the Denkitsu Shindaigaku, at the Chofu Station in Tokyo, but I'm not sure if the actual game is here.
No, not here. I think it's in Iidabashi, the center of Tokyo.
Yes. I see. Right, there was some kind of, well, many kinds of commentaries and so on in Japanese going on there.
Right.
Also an after party later on, of course.
Well, black has a choice of jump. I would suggest jumping, or could black could press, and again white can escape with this move. Or black could play something like this maybe.
And in case white blocks. In this case, it looks like white might get captured.
This would be losing more in the corner, but would be a stronger attack against the white stones.
Right. Could white think about linking up here? It loses points locally, but...
Well, it's the kind of thing you would expect Zen to do. It's the kind of, that's the kind of Zen-style move.
Right.
Black might play this side, actually, just to...
Ah, to create the cutting point. Mm. So then white also wants to connect here. So in that case, black plays elsewhere. Can I force this?
Only once.
Ah, the second one will...
Well, black would take that.
I just want to kind of fix this area. This is...
take it, yes.
This side?
No, I don't think so. I think black wants to take that side, yeah.
And then finally, white would have to come back here.
I think white would be able to probably live, yes.
But also the upper side is... Well, there's a weakness here. But
black
will be able to fix it.
To get that far, yeah.
Anything black plays around here
will be forcing.
It.
Yes.
Jump would be the easy move.
The easy move. There is a bit of after white plays something. There would be some weakness in black's connection, like if white plays this exchange.
If it happens to be sent.
And this one, white would be able to cut black there.
In this fashion.
So this would be bad, and that's why I'm suggesting maybe black wants to play the attachment against the corner, which would that would get rid of the bad agi of being cut off there.
Right. Ah, how about first attaching here? That's going to take one still, a bit smaller.
Looks like a trade. This could happen. Or black could play
Seems possible, yes.
If black doesn't like that, black would connect.
Right. So in this case, the double hana in the corner will be much more severe.
Yes, that might be better. So Ichiriki is already down to 18 minutes.
Zen still used 2 minutes so far.
So he's spending a lot of time in the beginning.
It does feel like Zen is attacking strongly from the beginning here.
Yes. Well, I think Japanese players tend to have a kind of a tradition of spending a lot of time in the beginning.
Ah, yes.
Just because it's so hard to know what the correct move is. It's,
right.
It's a fascinating part of the game.
Kind of philosophical area almost.
Yes. But at the same time, top Chinese or Korean players tend to play more quickly in the opening.
Right.
And they have openings ready.
They basically memorize the openings, play them out quickly.
And not necessarily doing anything original in the beginning.
Right.
But it's more efficient in that you tend to need time in the middle game.
Right. For the actual reading and so on, life and death discussion starts. Which can actually be very decisive in the final score. Uh-huh.
I think he played here.
Yes.
The idea behind this move is to play here and then play the attack.
Right.
And if white answers, all of this would be good for black. Black could even just leave it and start the attack now.
Right.
But of course, white will not answer that way.
White might first of all play this way.
Even in this position, white will play there first. Yes, that would be okay. And black would probably want to play once here now.
Right.
And this exchange is not necessarily good for black. But it indicates that black didn't like the idea of this variation.
Right.
But didn't think it was good enough and wanted to start here to get more forcing moves.
Yes.
Of course, in this position, there's also the possibility, yes, that white plays something stronger. But actually, white played here. That's a similar thing.
So,
like if black plays here, white will be able to cut black off with this move.
Right. So this variation seems like
black went for a trade, and white took the two stones, and black will probably push through here.
Yes.
Otherwise, this is also a good shape. It's a question of...
This is quite similar to what we were looking at.
If black pushes through here, then white will still have this move.
Right.
To make a life in the corner. So black's... But of course, it's stronger against white's lower
side.
So the question is this or this better?
Yes.
I don't really know. I sort of have a tendency to want to play here.
I would prefer that one as well. Mm. With this move, well, of course, if black can play like this as well, the territory is huge. Mm-hmm. But when white starts doing something immediately, I don't know what to do.
So black sacrificed these two stones, and so that's allowed white to live on the side, but black does get a lot back in the corner.
Right.
So it
used to be white's corner, after all. Mm. Black has used half of his thinking time already. I guess the push through is also a strong move.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe white doesn't have time to leave immediately. Or what do you think? Maybe after all, white is quick here.
White didn't play that way. Black did push through.
Up.
And white pushed here. So this is going to give black the corner and aiming to sacrifice.
Hmm.
And play forcing moves from the outside, probably something on the side.
Yes.
And black did not allow that, so black plays the hane on the top.
So it seems like white will get hane below in this case. Maybe this kind of shape.
Mm-hmm. I'd say this looks reasonably good for white. White's got a nice shape down
here. It does seem that way.
And is alive on the left side.
With 15 points, maybe.
Hmm. And black's thickness here doesn't really work well with the moyo up here. So it's a question of what can black do with the center now, afterwards. Well, one thing that can happen is black can eventually get a squeeze here, but will not be able to win the semi-ai. Like even after playing these two moves, white's still,
white is still going, killing
winning
the
semi-ai, yes. So an attacking here would, I think white has enough room to live though. Like if we assume something like this, it looks like it's a living shape. There's enough room.
Especially with no black stone here. Mm-hmm. Even if there was, maybe there's no difference.
I think white has room to live. Yes. So although black has various potential, so I wouldn't really call this 15 points. It might be a bit smaller. Hmm. But white does have that territory there and territory here.
And the corner
here
as well.
So, and then black has the the left upper left is probably can be called territory.
Yes.
And then the rest is just moyo. And of course, white is controlling the lower side. So it's this, it looks like it's at least even. I would sort of want to play with white, actually.
White is developing quickly on both sides. And black doesn't really know what to do about the lower right. Yep. He extended.
Now he extended.
Ten is actually playing very quickly here.
Mm-hmm.
This move came in like 7 seconds. Well, we can actually calculate it.
So since all the fighting has more or less ended at this point on the left side of the board,
mm-hmm.
This is probably a time when usually black would be thinking of moving to the lower left area. Black could try to attack a little bit more, but it's not going to kill the left side.
Right.
So this is a good time for black to be thinking of playing away.
Lower right corner.
Lower right corner, sorry. Yeah, so here would be a normal.
And for example,
The AI of Google would play maybe the Sansan here.
Ah, that could be possible.
It played it a few times in the 60 games it played over New Year's.
Right.
This is maybe the kind of position where I would expect it to jump in. But usually a player would play the approach move here.
Right.
And of course it's the human who's playing black in this game.
As far, that's interesting actually. I think in the master games, there was similar with something like this, preventing black from entering the corner and then playing a kind of pincer.
It did that a few times.
Which might actually fit the position here.
Hmm.
If white simply answers with one space jump, it looks like taking the corner is kind of big.
Mm-hmm. Well, the side, since white's alive here, the side is not so big.
Yes.
So I would think even white could play here.
Right, just to exchange that and then
jump,
go.
Yeah, and allow black to play here. And then, like if black plays here, white could invade and play the Hanesugi.
Solidify the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Whether black plays here or not, of course, it's difficult to say. Most likely he wouldn't. Now it looks like white is making a lot of territory
it's
on the lower side.
Yes. How to judge the center is probably a difficult part of this game. Like white might start moving to the center now.
Zen actually played the other attachment. It's also interesting. So Ichiriki approached and
white probably plans to play like this.
Right.
To take the corner.
Maybe down. Cut. Is it a push or?
Well, I don't know.
Difficult
the
to say.
The push is, would end up being a fight maybe, but if white plays here, it's relatively simple.
Right. It could be Chosuke. With something like this.
Yeah, it makes sense why it's building here. Right. Black would probably extend here.
It's also a very big point.
I don't know. The next move is hard to say.
Yes.
Sliding here also looks like it's a big move.
Yes. I don't actually remember about computer AI playing this attachment very much.
It is unusual. It in a way, it suits the position.
Yes.
And black wedged here. This depends on the ladder. When white connects here, black looks like black can win the ladder.
It'll be here.
Oh, but white did connect, cut underneath.
So perhaps extends. White is going to play a torii here.
In which case, black would play here. Yes. White does not have any co-threats.
No co-threats, so it's connection.
And black takes. Yes.
There seems to be something here.
It looks a bit thin.
Maybe white might consider forcing. Mm-hmm. It's kind of bad style, however. But yes, the game is proceeding this way. Mm-hmm. Black just played a torii.
Let's just show the variation, the moves here. Usually this is considered to be bad for white, though. So locally, it's probably a game for black. Mm-hmm. So they've come this far.
Connected and black took.
Yes.
Normally speaking, the shape black gets is quite thick. But of course, in this game, white is living in this area. So even the strong black group doesn't do so much.
Locally, I think it's good for black,
yes,
though, just to have this shape where white started with a cornerstone.
Right.
So they've come this far, and I'm expecting black to play here.
If black does not play anything, it looks like something quite around here. Mm-hmm. Will be quite severe. Black is actually not quite alive yet. If 10 were black, could it be possible to do something like this, maybe? And if cutting... Well, of course, white would just take a...
It doesn't gain very much. Hmm. Yes. Black might be able to take some stones on the left.
But this becomes weak. Yeah. Alternatively, playing honey on this side could be possible as well. And now whether white can take or not. Looks a bit dangerous for black, finally speaking. White peeped here.
Maybe white played the crow first.
Ah.
Yes.
All right, so then it's forcing for sure. Black connected. Maybe there's no problem. With this kind of move, it could be possible to aim here or possibly here, but white can bump.
Yeah, locally it doesn't work.
Black might try something like this, but mm-hmm. It looks a bit far.
Since black only has four liberties there. And
white will go out.
If we
white even has time to do something here.
If we look at it this way, then black has only four liberties and white has five, so
right.
Black's going to lose that semi.
The white shape is actually quite fine. Touched. So that is simply to prevent the black honey from being sent to. White likes to have this exchange here.
I think black will connect against that.
Yes.
Yeah.
So then
and the honey is sente next. So yeah, white.
White.
Once playing it, white probably has to play there.
Otherwise, it'll be just a loss by territory.
Well, that kind of reasoning, it doesn't always apply to the AI, of course.
Yes. If it was a human, it would be logical.
Yes.
If it's a computer, this might already be kind of, I don't know.
It's a bad exchange,
yes.
But... the AI sometimes doesn't worry about things that have happened already. So like a human would try to justify this move.
Right.
By playing, continuing with it.
And for computer, it might be time move or oversight. So here, Zen is thinking. Yep. Played elsewhere.
This is interesting. Well, again, we see the AI playing a shoulder hit, which seems to be a favorite move for AIs in general.
It is kind of good positioning.
It's a position where we really wonder what's going to happen in the center. So white's trying to build some strength towards the center while reducing the upper side.
Right.
So it does make sense. And if black does, for instance, if black does go for the upper side, then this is not very efficient because the side here is open.
Maybe around here?
Yes. So it's not really worthwhile for black to be surrounding the side like
still
this.
Still not territory.
When it's still not territory. So it's more likely that usually against the shoulder hit, you want to push one side or the other. So
yes.
Maybe
and if this is not good, it would be this side.
Then white would jump anyway.
And well, if this position were different, black might do something like wedge here. This kind of thing.
Yes.
But of course, this shape here is already strong. So
it's a bit over-concentrated.
Yes.
So maybe black will crawl once and then play elsewhere, like, for instance, something like this.
Right. That would look good. Ichiriki has 6 more minutes left. Black did play the crawl. White's jump here would be normal.
Black would like to be able to find some way to attack the lower side.
Can I try?
Yes.
It's a far off plan, but.
Well, while playing the ko, white
yes,
also plays.
Yes, and
here.
Black has to play here as well.
Well,
so it's kind of one move approach.
That's a yoseko.
And this might still.
Then
it
white
becomes a very far off
later
plan.
Later on, play here, it's even further off.
Yes.
So that's a bit distant. Otherwise, black could try the attachment here.
Right.
In which case.
Can white bump? So this might become so that. White's eye shape might be weakened. And that also became center. This looks quite severe. The one white stone is clearly, well, inefficient. White would not die, but he lost quite a bit of territory, didn't he?
But actually, white can. Let's go through that once more.
I missed something. Down. Is there a better
resistance? White can take from this side. And black will connect. And here. So white.
I see. So there's a eye difference here.
Can sacrifice these two stones.
I see.
And live on this side. So this would not be so impressive for black.
Right.
Otherwise, black can play the final move here.
In which case, white can
live. Yes.
Something like this could actually happen.
So this would be a territorial profit for black, and this move would probably be a bad exchange. Let's
right.
see. That actually loses something like 1 or 2 points already. So it's a slight loss for white, but it's not something that an AI would really notice, I don't think.
Especially this early in the game.
And this is looks like it. This is probably not going to work for white, though, because black plays here. And now this is going to work for black.
Right. So this is simply a black win.
It's an eye against no eye.
Shall
so
we
yes.
Shall we return to the game? Something is happening.
Yeah, we should catch up with the moose. So there's a bit of potential there, but it doesn't look like black can actually kill white. So black
white
played the attachment here.
I think it was yes. So Hane.
This is also a tesuji that is used quite often. And black played Atari.
And then white countered.
Yes. And black will take the ko here because white doesn't have any ko threats. I expect black to take the ko. He stopped playing now. Yeah, white would connect.
And then try to find a way to attack white here.
Yes.
Maybe around here. Here.
Well, I would try to cut this area off. It looks like white can sort of connect, come out. Because black's given white a lot here, so black wants to attack on a big scale.
I see.
So I would want to start with something like this.
And assuming, for example, that white defends this cutting point, maybe here.
Mm, yeah. And then something like this. Mm-hmm.
So now black also has a move here later on. Then white might run out, which gives black perfect reason to move in this area.
Yeah. And so white's developing some territory here. And the question is what will happen in the center after all. Mm. And while we were looking at positions like this, I'm sure some people will have noticed that there's a little bit of Aji, like black has all these different forcing moves against this stone. So this could have some effect on the fight in the center of the board.
Right. Let's see. We are at the point where white just defended.
We're at this point. So black took the ko, white connected, and the upper side is still like this.
Right. Ichiriki has 3 minutes remaining, so the game will actually speed up very soon.
So it looks like white, if white surrounds the whole side here, it's going to be something like 40 points. Mm-hmm. And then white has two relatively small territories. Like this
It'll
one
be 20
was,
maybe.
This was about 6 points before.
Yes.
And this is...
Not quite 15, but... It's,
well, I don't think it's 15. I think there's a possibility for since black can sometimes attack this and make it relatively small. It's more maybe 10 points,
10 points,
maybe not. So I think these added together, I'd count them for about 15 points.
I see.
So that would, but if white gets the whole side here, it's going to be 40, so that makes
55. Will be bigger.
Black has about 10 here, and probably close to 10 here. Mm-hmm. And that's about 20, just to be probably a bit more than 20, actually.
Right. 22,
so,
23.
So black still needs, if this is going to be a white territory, black still needs about 20 more points.
So he has to get quite
that
a bit
would,
by attacking
that these
would stones.
Involve capturing these. And of course, since white does have the slide here, depending on how black goes about it, white might just sacrifice those two.
Right.
So it all depends on the fight in the center. And black would like to make it as big a fight as possible.
Black peeped here.
He peeped. I don't think white's going to try to save that.
It looks like even if white gets cut off because of this slide here,
it's
black
not,
is not getting so much.
It's not so big. I think white would rather be playing something on the outside, like, for instance, like this.
Hmm.
Of that course, white might even go this far.
It might be white black cannot actually enter that one. And now the connection next seems like it might also hana here.
Mm-hmm.
So black would almost have to answer.
Yeah, I think that would be good for white, actually. I think
Zen
white,
did connect, however.
Zen connected, okay. So that means after playing the peep here, I think black probably wants to... this makes
that way.
This actually, this exchange makes the white pushing here a bit more effective,
mm-hmm.
Just because white has such a good connection. Something like that, even, yes.
Is there no way to get a connection? Well, here, once. Maybe it's a bit far. Trying to look up this kind of thing, but it seems like
doesn't really work.
Yes.
No. So maybe white will just play the hane.
Simpler way then.
And white can connect up here with something like this.
Mm-hmm.
So it's since this becomes more effective with this exchange, black will probably do something to stop it, and he did. Yeah.
Ah yes. So now white is going to be running out from this direction. Even this one seems kind of difficult for black to catch. Normally generally speaking, around here. White plays.
Mm-hmm. Then somewhere around here.
Somehow it looks like this will become a bad move.
Otherwise, black could pull this out.
So then, well, would be connection here. That looks better.
Mm. All right, he played this way. The meaning is quite similar.
Yes, cutting point here.
To cut there, yes.
Ah, it looks like Ichiriki is now in Pyoyomi.
Yes.
He will play every move in 30 seconds.
And Zen actually still has 25 minutes.
Yes. Push now. So it looks like a cut will follow.
Maybe. Mm-hmm.
Now black doesn't really want to play here anymore. This has to be a drawback. So white would be connected.
Mm-hmm.
And actually this is not such a big territory either, is it? Ah, it's fine. The stone gets captured.
Next stone gets captured, okay. Yes.
That's not a big deal.
Hmm. So it's close to 30 points, but the white group did escape. So
right. And actually, this area, black is still a bit thin.
Right. So this would be okay for white. Otherwise, if black crawls here, then white can play here.
Right. In which case, this is going to be a connected shape.
More or less connected. So black took from above. And this gives white some extra eye space on the upper side. So now white can play here. This looks like white should be able to make a life.
Right.
White probably has about one eye on the upper side.
Feels like there's some kind of...
Yes. Oh, the connection. Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, otherwise, yeah, looks like white can manage at least to live.
Yes.
Like white could play this way and
even
then just
trade that
cover
one.
Here. Yeah. Actually, white covered immediately.
I suppose it doesn't make a difference, finally speaking. So white is quite unattackable. Already.
So this was a success for white, I think.
Yes. Black really has to prevent this from becoming white territory, but that is looking increasingly hard. That's a live shape. White played the side immediately.
So that's connected. The question is, how can black enter the side here?
Right.
Black would like to be able to play the ko, but I don't really see any good ko threats for black.
Something
this would be the biggest, yeah.
There's still quite a bit of Aji remaining in the area.
I like this for white, actually.
It is quite big, isn't it? Black will have 20 here. A bit more, 22, and the lower side.
So black did not yet play the call. But instead attached here. Now this is a tesuji. And black can continue with this one.
If white were to simply connect here, for example, black will be playing here, I suppose. And then, of course, if white connects, the two stones get captured. So, locally speaking, it would have to be here. In which case, now the extension is going to be painful.
So this is how you attack it. Oh, but he didn't do that.
Is there some reason to avoid it?
Without the extension.
Yes. Yeah. Was there something more severe for white? Simply giving up one stone.
Well, that would be better for black, even if white lives. And it's not a complete life.
Yes.
Like black would be able to fight this call.
It's actually not even one eye here. It looks like a move you would like to play, but he didn't. And computer AI never plays this kind of move. It's playing inside your own territory. They always seem to want to go outside. Black pushed. Now it's going to be a perfect shape. Well, there's a little bit something still.
It's still not very good, right. So maybe white wants to play this way. Pulled back.
Yes.
And now black can still play here. So it's still kind of a coal-like position.
Of course, white is running out, so...
This would also be a bit of trouble.
Yes. Could actually white sacrifice two stones?
White could sacrifice, but it's
a loss by territory.
So he tried that out now. White can sacrifice the two stones, but that would be losing...
Quite a lot of territory. Here.
Oh, it's better to play it this way.
Oh, I see.
But maybe not. Black plays the targets. And then cuts. So yeah, that works for black.
Right. So the two stones are captured already.
Yes.
But also alive.
But instead white played
Touchment.
This way. And it's not 100% alive locally. Like black can play here. And take the call.
And later, sooner or later.
And it's not completely alive. But it
yes.
Black first has to fight the call here.
And of course, and white is always white has almost unlimited call threats by running out.
Yeah, so it's a bit a lot of distance that black has to travel to actually kill the group.
We lost connection for a bit, but we're back. We still have lost connection.
I think we are missing this screen, but
yes.
It looks like
this looks like
Ichidiki is playing the ko here.
White didn't answer. I think the moment black played this move, white played elsewhere.
Indeed. I think we might have to wait for our connection to come back.
Ah, no, you're right. You're right.
Okay.
At this point,
then connected.
Yes.
So black would like to push through here once to make sure white's not alive, but white is out into the center.
Ah, it did push. Well, white can just answer, I suppose. Does he want to?
Well, either answer or take the call.
In case of taking call, could it be possible for...
White can afford that, I think.
Ah, it becomes a living shape.
And then can connect all the way to the queen. Right. So this would be efficient for white.
Okay.
So black will fight the queen and force white to connect on the third line.
It seems white did capture. Black will play a queen threat. Well, black isn't really losing anything here.
So black has about 40 points in all. And white has, if we count this area as white's territory, black will is sort of behind in territory.
Yes.
So at some point while attacking this, black's going to try to get into the right side. So if we don't, if we don't count this area, white just has about 10 points here, and almost 10 points here, and about 10 points here. So 40 points, black, counting these, there's, this is in the vicinity of 20. And these are in about 10 each. So black has at least 40 points. So if we count this as zero, then black has enough territory. So a lot depends on what happens with this territory, the potential territory here.
Black just took back.
And now white will connect on the third line.
Yes. And then the question is how to do the center.
Well, a safe kind of move would be this one.
Right.
White would probably play something around here and to put a little pressure on black.
So if white can play here as well, black is not going to be
or
alive.
Or white could do it from that side too. That's also a big move. Maybe white will play this side.
Oh, yes. That's also one eye here. That looks like a time move. It does look a little bit tough to mount an attack on the white group. Even if it becomes troublesome, white will still capture here.
Yes.
And if black really wants to kill the group without core, he has to connect, in which case white has many forcing moves in this area.
Even just playing the simple way this way, white
can make another eye. So there's one eye here.
It's not as if it's in immediate danger of dying. So after this exchange, maybe it's a good time for black to cut here and use one of these co-threats.
And white still doesn't really have co-threats.
White doesn't have any co-threats. So this is probably big enough.
Yes.
And black can force this and then maybe just continue with a fight here.
There's a little bit something here, but right now it's a bit too early. So this could become a kind of splitting attack?
Well, I don't know if black can actually attack white, but at least get rid of the white territory.
Right. So black would be connecting
well,
out.
Well, we haven't come this far, but black did play the cut. So let's get back to the game position.
And white also did capture. So we were at this
so
point.
He was setting up this quadrat, I think. This is a big quadrat.
Yes, as you were saying.
So that was the meaning of all of the moves black was playing here on the upper side, just to make the quadrat bigger.
So white would have trouble now. Well,
white has no choice, but white just doesn't have any quadrats worthy of this call.
So.
And the shape move is to extend here, but this looks a bit dangerous. I'm not sure, but even if white pushes,
there's going to be a nasty cut there.
And black has to extend the liberties here.
That Let's looks see. Dangerous. Mm.
This way, black can capture white. Mm-hmm. So if white plays here, though. Now, how is this going to turn out? If black cuts...
Ladder is good for white. Black can simply capture this way.
Oh, he can capture that way. Yes. Oh, that's easy. So black has to play here, and white can play here. It looks like white's going to win this
match. Yes.
White will have about five moves, five liberties. So
black
only has
four.
Something like, if white plays here, black probably already has only about four liberties. Maybe four, yeah.
Looks like four.
But since white has five, that's going to be good enough. So that's why I was suggesting maybe black's going to play here. Mm-hmm. Oh, but he didn't do that. He played a more light move.
Ah. Mm-hmm. And white just played a tarry here. Be forcing. Is white going to connect in that case?
And looking at the hane here.
Yes. Can black white do it immediately? Seems to be too far.
Black, white has died.
Yes.
White, black has four liberties, and white cannot escape from
this. Yes.
White only has three.
For the time being.
White can't do it yet.
So white would first have to play something like touch there.
And extend.
Yes. But in this case, now it would be working.
That's a double threat there. So this looks like it's a bit dangerous for black, because if black plays on this side, white would even play here.
Right.
The whole position here is...
It's very thin for black, isn't it? It could still be... Well, even just play a tarry should be.
Or even taking the stone here.
Oh, yes.
Doesn't... Even this way, it doesn't look very happy for black. Even
right. The even whole if black here, somehow got out.
The whole group here is rather weak.
Oh, yes. Push once, maybe. Okay.
I would not be happy with black at in this position.
This could black actually be dying fairly soon?
Well, that kind of attack could also happen. Yeah, but, black might be able to connect up to the side there. Mm-hmm. But it's white who's going to be attacking. So maybe black doesn't want to pull this one stone out.
It looks a bit far off.
Mm-hmm. Might be better to play something
inside. He did. White played diagonal.
Diagonal. Yeah, that works too.
So that's a press here.
Again, white. Yeah, black has to protect this side, maybe here, and then white can press. Yes. So that's the aim that for white.
And this is also the way that the game. Well, this move doesn't exist yet, but black just played the hane.
Mm-hmm.
It's a press. If black gets captured here, the game will be over.
Yes. Well, the question is, can black sort of turn this around into an attack against these stones?
Oh, yes. Could it have been enough just to jump simply? That's the attachment, maybe? It seems black gets out this way.
Mm.
In this case, black will cut, of course. So white will have to try for some kind of double attack, maybe.
Something like that. Maybe white will play here first.
Just to take the eye out.
Yes.
Peep here and then cut. That'll be dead. Black
so
seems to be getting very busy.
Yes.
We're at the point where black just cut. Ah, white played a tori.
Again, so white is probably going to play something towards the center.
Yes.
Yes.
And next, exchange this, and diagonal here should still be capturing. Ichiro Kiryusei is using all his time here. It's interesting how time management is also a kind of skill for a pro to know.
Yes.
You have a Byoyomi of 30 seconds, which means that even if the move is something very obvious, like going out from here, you want to use the 28 seconds or so you have to think ahead what happens afterwards, even if the move right now is obvious.
Well, yeah, that's the system of
second
reading that we use. Of course, there are various ways that it can be done.
Right.
As we see in the games on the internet.
Right.
So it's...
Nowadays, well, the Japanese second reading is still quite normal. But for example, in Finland recently, we have a kind of Fischer system they use in chess.
I like the Fischer second reading, actually.
Yes, because that way you don't actually have to optimize your time usage. You can concentrate on the game. Fischer is that after each move you play, your basic time is increased by a set number of seconds or minutes.
So like they use it a lot in the chess tournament. So
yes.
That's why it's, I think it's named after Bobby Fischer. It was his idea
I think so,
to start
yes.
with, maybe.
Yes.
And so you can like have almost no time on the clock to start with.
Right.
And give 3 seconds for each move. And if you play quickly enough, then you end up with after the opening, you have plenty of time.
Yes, especially in chess where the games are quicker.
Yes.
It's possible. In Finland, we use something like 10 seconds maybe, or 12 or 15.
And the value of such a system is that you can multiply the number of seconds by the number of moves you expect the game to be.
Right.
And that will be the amount of time it takes to finish the game. So it's a very good way for the tournament directors.
It's very easy to count, right?
Yes.
Whereas Japanese Byoyomi, it can get increasingly long. If you have 1 hour basic time and 1 minute per move, the players might play 10 moves in the 2 hours they have. And then it might still be like 200 moves more and 1 minute each. It could become 5-6 hours, theoretically.
Well, when white played this move, compared to this move, it's more difficult for white to kill this group. For instance, when black cuts here, white probably needs to add a stone here.
Yes.
And black can play this, and white has to add another stone here.
Now
and black can push through.
Right.
And white cannot go ahead like that and kill the group.
Is it not possible to peep?
Oh, that way, yes. Maybe
well,
it works
of course,
after
these
all.
Stones get out, but this tail gets captured.
But of course, otherwise, white might be planning to do something like this.
Ah, I see.
And allow black to escape.
And then go maybe here?
Maybe play another move here, just to make
sure
of the connection. Yes. And, well, actually, white could maybe even do it this way, yes. But this whole, these stones in the center are going to die.
Right.
And this is probably going to be good enough for white. I mean, that's pretty big, too.
Yes. It almost looks like whichever way white picks, it'll be good. We are at the point where black just played the bulge. Maybe that's a weird word for it.
So white would like to peep now, but maybe this doesn't work. Let's see. If white peeps, then the latter favors black, so black would play.
Ah, yes. Black would have to go through.
Yes. And it would be the latter or capturing these stones.
Could white go for trade? Ah, no. It was easy. So these 3 stones will get captured.
Mm-hmm. So white can't go that far. White needs to play something in the center.
He played jump.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And black will push through. Yes.
Jump almost feels like white is going to do this way.
Or will black try to make eyes? Black could otherwise try to make eyes with something like this.
And then, because this is forcing.
It doesn't, black doesn't need that.
Ah, it doesn't need, right.
Or unless he plays here and then plays
right
this way.
That seems a bit better, since in this case,
it's more territory, yeah.
White can capture two stones here in center.
Yes. So maybe he'll just do this one first, and then live like this.
Ah, but he made the eye. Is the situation.
Well, he can still play here.
It doesn't change.
And play this next time.
Yes.
But again, these stones are sort of cut off, so white can continue.
Can white even
like
go this far?
Yes.
And next, black has to try to weigh his way around this weakness. But
since
as long as white has this one.
Right. So let's see. Black gained a lot here, and black has more than 10 points here, less than 10 points here. So that's about 20. And adding this is at least 20 points.
This could be 25.
So black has about 45. White has 15 here.
Yes.
And almost 10 here.
Right.
And about 10 here at least. So that's already 35.
Right.
And then white's going to get a lot here.
Most likely the three stones will at least die.
So that looks like it could be easily about 25 points of territory. And black has to, next playing here is going to be a strong attack against this group.
So actually, it's black alive.
Black really needs to play a stone here, in which case white can add a stone somewhere around here just to make sure.
This is going to be very big. Yeah. This looks like 40 points.
It adds up to about 40 points. It looks like white's already winning.
Yes. So white played here.
Force with that. White's just making some extra eye space here. And then white can play here.
It's white's turn now. Simply here. That's solid.
It's playing safe.
Well, it still does seem like black cannot run out. Even this
black time. Still really needs a stone here.
Yes.
And I would play here with white. Yeah, that's definitely more than 40 points just there.
Yes.
And so white has over 60 points.
Black's this territory became just bigger, but still.
So I didn't really expect it to be this bad for Ichiriki, but it looks like he's losing pretty badly at this point.
Will he try something like this? Doesn't seem like white will be troubled. Maybe simply covering is good. Even if black tries this kind of thing, there's not going to be enough eye shape. At this point, white can play there, yes.
And the corner here isn't alive either, so.
Right.
Even if black somehow manages to save these stones,
this
corner is going to die. So this is, there's just no way that it can work for black.
White played higher even then. Black extended and white played a net. That's also a solid way of play.
I think the game is approaching its end, actually.
Yes.
I don't see any way that black can get out of this.
This looks like a resign sequence. Zen did actually play impressively strong in this game.
Well, I think the fight on the left side here, in which white took these two stones and
also
gave the corner
group
to black.
Lower side.
That move that Ichiriki was thinking so long about, the attachment here, it didn't work very well when white's weak group became this territory here.
Right.
So I don't and all of black's attacking stones
also
were not
became a kind of target.
Well. Yeah. So I think that's where Ichiriki went wrong in this game.
Oh, he's still playing.
Well, Tetsuji, of course, is to cut here.
Yes. Simply speaking, white could just let part of the black group maybe this way is better.
That way, yes.
So like this. And then push out maybe for simplicity.
No, maybe even simpler to play here. But actually, white could just leave this at any point.
True.
And kill the corner first. I think it's safer, actually, to kill the corner.
Even just exchanging, well, that's going to be dead. There is no way, is there? No, there's not. In the game, white jumped.
No, jumping is, I might have made a mistake there. Jumping is simpler.
Oh, right, because this stone is now alive. And Ichiriki resigned. So, well, altogether, as we were saying, white took a lead early on in the game, and
yes,
there was not much black could actually do.
And just to recap, going yes, back to this position here, maybe, why don't we take a look at it?
Yes.
Like this, and black was attacking these stones, so I think black should have made the play out from these stones. I would have played this way and just made a connecting group to move out and attack these stones, and black would still have a potential attack against white's
right
left side group. So this would be the way I would play. I think in the game, the way black played this way, now black, there's no turning back. Like if black comes here, this would
this
just
stone
be
is
so
be
terrible
wasted,
and completely wasted. It would be a
it's stone, minus one
yeah,
move directly.
It's minus one move, yeah. So black was sort of forced to make the trade. And so in this variation, white actually did sacrifice the corner and made a position on the side. So white got this side and that side.
And black and actually didn't have so much territory in the corner.
And so it, even locally, white was playing both sides, but the big point of it is that these two stones were vital for the attack against this group, which black had already spent a number of moves on.
Right.
And throwing them away like this was, it was just too valuable. So
yes,
I think after this first fight, black was already having a hard time.
Yes. And white basically just kept an easy game, kept to his lead, took territory.
This
but
was well
after
played.
White erased this area. I guess there was nothing much more to do. Just down here.
Yes. So this is in this game, Zen was actually looking even better than it did a few days
in the
ago.
Three
yes
games, yes, in the World Go Championship. So I think we will enter a break now.
Yes.
And the game of Ichiriki Ryo against Fine Art, the winner of the UEC Cup, will start at 2:30 Japanese time.
So
in
two and
a half
hours
from
now, yes.
Stay tuned. Thank you.